The street is my world. I don't pretend to go uptown and be anything fancy. I can, but I find more real in the world that I'm in than I do the tinsel. And the real world is the one I have to deal with every day, you know? Believe me, if I started murdering people, there'd be none of you left.
Let the bass kick.
Playtime been over since y'all dropped the ball. Bound to the continent, there's no asylum for y'all. Pushing the black Asiatic game with Fort L and Pool Bay. Before NOI, I rep draw L all day. How many fakes proclaim to be the reincarnation and claim to be the true head of the Moorish nation? No mention of Mealy Eel, but I read his letters. Dirty Moors mad cause they thought they dead as letters. Many were there when decisions were handed down. Now they claim that Mealy Eel was not ordained, not commissioned, not called or appointed. With the Vine plans for ages, but Dirty Moors making changes. Working with FBI during infiltrations. Inner Pheasant Alley's giving bogey smoke inhalations. And secret walls are made, heads are made in public mentions. Don't believe, get the minutes of the first convention. Kirkman and Lomax Bay got called out as villains against the Prophet Sorted and L called Givens. Thousands of Moorish Americans follow those leaders that killed the Prophet and made Moors parrots not readers. They don't study, brains hollow. To crush the truth, plant dissension in the ones that follow. Robbed the treasury, felt like they hit the lotto. Took advantage of the faithful Moors in their times of sorrow. Moment still critical, 100 years later, the message. Stick to the principles in your actions, be progressive. Don't sell your soul for a title, take your membership role. Watch out for grand cheeks pushing you in a censorship hole. The sellout was great, now they're comfy and won't get the hell out. Active Moors come around, they get clumsy. Not humbly, but act grumpy and jumpy. Active Moors see them touchy and think it's lovely. With faces ugly, I push back so don't shove me. If not for love, it would be just as Dirty Moors get from me. Hitting all reincarnates with writs of discovery and demanding the treasury recovery and law for money. Wearing affairs don't make you a Moorish adept. Dirty Moorish heads are Boy Scouts and cadets. Working for FBI inspectors, slaves for gadgets. Claiming they got pulled, but they really dead magnets. Running a fraud that's done, cause new Moors are here. One for all for one profit like musketeers. Bay, not Tampa or Buccaneers. I strike nerves like harp or strings on those puppeteers. Pushing misconceptions as teachings and calling it facts. Swinging my scimitar tongue, not a fireman's axe. Quick to call me out as dirty, say I violate acts. If you don't nationalize, know that I annihilate blacks. Nail them through their palms and incepts on beams of wood. Burn crosses on black lawns in my Moorish hood. Black Klansmen like movie from 1960s. White power, not supremacy like Clayton Bigsby. Now I run through illusions, battling my arch nemesis, misconfusion. She's been trying to keep me out of course, facing losses, calling all her negative forces. 99 years passed, Drew Ali said 50 would pass. And you wouldn't know about me, or even know what I brought for you. NOI and UNIA knew about him too. Most thought that they could bury the movement, be in charge, passive and abuse it. But Drew said new Moors would come with eyes open, seeing and knowing, far from hoping. Far from belief and faith, master fruition. Study the laws of nature, activate intuition. One day our wheels of industry will stop, and when it starts again, Moors will be on top. Drew Ali blessed with latent power. Warned you, get out the way or be ground to powder. Drew Ali didn't kill you fast, but he brought you your title and estate vast. Confusion continues to confuse, no remembrance of Maghrib al-Aqsa by Moorish descendants. Now I run through illusions, battling my arch nemesis, misconfusion. She's been trying to keep me out of course, facing losses, calling all her negative forces.
There's a natural mystic flow through the air. If you listen carefully now, you will hear. This could be the first trumpet, might as well be the last. Many more will have to suffer, many more will have to die. Don't ask me why.
quote-unquote sentenced to some European guidelines. upstate, what I mean? But that's basically like a quote-unquote city-county jail almost. It's kind of crazy.
But the point again, they're corporations. That's a corporate establishment. Mm-hmm. So, again, we raise the point to the Moors waking up, on their position and how they should be handling these things in the first place. So, it's all in line with the divine order. But a lot of things happen where it's the window for action. When I say action, I mean active activity, like Moorish Divine National Movement is for active Moors. Or that's what it means. It means to be active. As the prophet said, I want active Moors, not passive. So that being brought up. And another thing being brought up, and let me see if Sammy 8 is on the line yet. He's not. Oh, he is. No, that's not her. Another thing is that, she'll text me when she goes on, is that, this is a lot going on right now. Now, I'm going to say the dirty word everybody doesn't like. We say that. But guess what? We didn't make up the word study. We got the directions just like everyone else. And so, there's Prophet Nwadrelli said it, for certain. And that's based on whatever your situation is or what have you. So now there's a lot of people who are, trying to catch up or whatever like that, and that's fine. You'll find yourself where you can solve your problems best. Now, the Prophet Nwadrelli made that statement too. He said you will find yourself where you can solve your problems best, not where someone else can solve them for you. You see, because that's the point that he's making. And it doesn't mean that we don't build, but see, there's a lot, the mindset, we're in a mental slavery, so there's a lot of people who are trying to, catch up and know they have to go down this road. It's not my road. It's your road, right? And so what you have is what did the prophet say was your savior? He said if you are looking for your savior, you must look within. If you are looking for your devil, you must look within. Now, there are some people in these days and time who want to be saviors for those who may not have hit that mile marker yet in their own sojourn, And so what it leads me to is to reinforce right now the chapter, the Secret Brotherhood of the East. I'm bringing up on my computer. I don't have it in front of me right this second. But it basically said, who is this that, where are these words that you're saying come from? Who is the teacher, that has given you this truth? And then Yahshua says, no, this truth has never been shut up. There is no teacher. Now you go back to the teacher appears when the student is ready. Now I'm saying this because I'm not talking about everyone. I'm only, for those who have eyes, ears to listen and eyes to see. What we're saying is you have been reminded. It is really obvious now that we have been in a very, very serious mental slavery still going on. Again, may I interject, you will find yourself where you can solve your problems. So you have, again, people who, in other words, we're talking about saving a whole nation, acknowledging a whole nation of people that we are. And, of course, it starts with self first. So you have, if you're going to just look for someone to do everything for you, right, then you may as well. I understand now why Prophet Nwadrelli left that statement, go back to the state in which I found you if you don't believe in this information, period. And then it's like, well, what do you want me to do, kill you? I never did quite get that one, but I get it now. Because what it is that a lot of us, we don't want to go through this. We don't want to go through what it is we have to go through. It's like we just don't want to be a part of it. Now, those are the people who now in these days, very well what the program has been to enslave the people and fictitiously enslave. I didn't say slaves, because the only slaves on the planet are Slavic. That's it. Everyone knows that with the books that are coming out, as well as books that have already been out, but our mindset has not been towards walking in this light of truth. And most everyone, whether you are more unconscious, not conscious or unconscious, whether you're a modern European, whatever, everyone knows that it's about, you know, birthrights and nationality and the fact that we've been mentally enslaved. So we're all walking towards that light. However, as I'm saying, with knowing that truth, there's some people who just, they don't wish to deal with it. Now, 10 years ago, 15 years ago, 20 years ago, maybe even 100 years ago, I don't know. I wasn't here 100 years ago that I can recall. So if some people don't want to face this, then it's like, okay, what do you want me to do, kill you? Like, in other words, so you don't have to face this journey? No, you're going to face this journey because reality, you know, it's just a matter of paradigm. It's just a matter of dimension. You're going to find yourself right back to where you can solve your problems best. And it says solve them. Solve them. Not you can't run from them, you know. And when I say that, I don't just mean some particular citation. I mean, we as people who are striving to our higher self, because that's the only way you're going to get that light, that marvelous light. That's it and that's all. Not saying anyone is perfect or anything like that. No one on this line is either. But that is really what it is, that striving towards that. You know, that's your journey. So, a last thing, and I don't know if you heard this or know about this, I want to say this. One of the reasons why, in terms of our proclamation process, that we began asking for a photo, be a formal one, to the ceiling, for the ceiling. It just needed to be something to go off of generally to know whether or not, you know, we're looking at family, or more so that we definitely are not looking at the family in terms of the nation, in terms of, you know, the bloodline, in terms of, you know, being obvious or heirs apparent, as we would say. That's what that means, heirs apparent. It's not that there's any prejudice against modern Europeans or anything, but it is that when you read the declaration, the proclamations, it says for those who have been, as an example, for those who have been coined Negro, colored, and black, and then the prophet reiterates that and tells you were branded and coined Negro, colored, and black. So we know this, and we also know this through studies in history. So even though modern Europeans, as we're finding out, are the original Negroes, and the original blacks. Now, that might go over the head of some, and if it does, then get to studying, and you will see this all to be true, inclusive of, you know, language etymology, because black originally means pale. I know what we think it means today, but we have to be real clear that everything has been reversed because there is a usurpation of the birthright. So we asked for the photo, because there was a lot more Europeans that were trying to take that position, and a few of them got through. There's a brother that got through now. The prophet told you that the Europeans are helping, why not you? Again, we're not judging that, but we understand now that one of these European brothers is being attacked by that, what's that name of that TV show that brother Taharqa or something is on? It's not the Moorish News.
No.
What's it?
Morrisco World. Morrisco World TV.
Yeah, Morrisco World TV.
What?
No, Morrisco World TV. Morrisco World TV.
All right, so okay. Check it out. So now, right. So now there's an
yeah,
attack.
I was just going in on their chat room because they're talking crazy. And you know what? When I was hearing, my fault, I don't mean to cut your wisdom, but I do want to speak because I want to go over some things, but please go in. Just go in.
Well, yeah. I want to bring this to the table tonight. You know, so now these guys are now attacking this one brother, and I think they're, I know Cujo got something to say too, because I think here's what they're asking them. also have asked him, who's your teacher? Now, let me say something about that. This is where those who are in temples and secret societies, because temple is not a secret society, but they have once infiltrated, that's what it became. Now, you know that's not right because the prophet already told you, I am taking the cover off of all secret societies. Very well, if you study his work, you will see. But, you know, so now they're asking those questions. Now, people who ask that, who's your teacher, who's your grand sheikh, you know what I mean, like that. These are telltale signs for us to realize how important it is for us to be our own savior and go down this road and read the prophet's work and find out, you know, what's really, really going on, and that these people, these temples, a lot of them have been infiltrated too and are acting like secret society clubs, you know, and they're just showing themselves to be that, you know what I'm saying? So now they have, again, go back to the secret teaching of the Brotherhood of the East. It tells you about the teacher and the truth and the light, and the prophet tells you about the marvelous light. But there's nothing wrong with coming together and effectuating all of these natural principles, whether you're in a temple or any other type of association that is proper, that's active more. So now I just wanted to hit on that is that I understand that now they're going after this European, which is one of the ones that got through with us. Nothing personal against them, but we had to explain to them, you are not the heir. You are not one who was coined Negro rather than black. Yes, you are the original Negro, but these papers are for those who were coined, which is the only reason why we cannot, you know, give that to one of another nationality. I mean, here's the simplicity of it. If I ask you what's your nationality and they say I'm Irish, I'm French, I'm whatever, well, there you go right there. That's not what this is. Then the same thing about being Irish. You know what I'm saying? So these are the things that we have to take into consideration. And lastly, and this is why we've done it. So now these people are these infiltrators, because that's what they are. And I say that because, you know, this noise about, you know, these people talking about who's your grand sheik and I'm the temple. Now, if you're coming in, we understand that why anyone would be searching out for the prophet's work. And that is why we suggest it highly and put it on the site. If you want to join the temple, you know, we suggest Canaan land is North America, and that's where Cujo is the grand sheik of. Now, we did that not too long ago, but long enough ago for the attacks to start coming, because think about it. It's what I'm thinking. Now, y'all can correct me if I'm wrong. But, you know, you were always doing the work. We were always associated, but it's like that scandal thing and that you know, we're sitting they're sitting in their seat and just trying to knock down everything that's happening, because if the people who are searching and looking for the right direction of information, because all we do is share information. So first, let's get that real clear. We're nobody's teacher, guide, leader, whatever like that. We just share information. So that's the first thing. And if you find that information to be right and exact or true to you or speak to your soul, because you know you got to follow the dictates of your soul, not the dictates of anyone else, so then go forward, and we're all on that same journey. But now it's like an attack. And here comes these guys that are Moriscos. They are clearly Moriscos. And that is a definition that you would look up and know what that means. Converted, what's the other word? Well, today we call them sellout. It's a shame, but it is what it is. So now there's that attack, you know. But we stand tall. And I just trust that you'll find yourself where you can solve your problems best. Is there any other comment on that? Because we were like shocked that this guy from this TV show, Tahaka, was saying anything about anybody. We thought they were handling their own problem.
Let's just say this. With regard to these individuals and the claim that they're making right now that they found somebody who used RV-based stuff and it didn't work, and then when they called, they didn't get hold of anybody and all this stuff, try to create this propaganda again. The founder of RV Bay Publication just told you that all it is sharing information. Nobody's brand, whatever, because they went to rvbaypublications.com website. They're not somebody's leader. Now, they're going to bring somebody who got in a situation, right, to try to make it look like this information is not credible, because here's somebody who, you know, it appears that they got abused because they used this information that these people are pushing us, and it didn't work. How, where are they when they, you know, how come they're not helping this person with their situation or whatever, right? We'll use the example of Brother Rennie Bay, right, who was on the list of the kidnapped Moors, right? He was on the list. His name got shouted out, all right? He's been liberated, not because of some Moorish whatever, or he tried some Moorish whatever, but because as a man, he took responsibility for his effort. As a real Moorish American that knows that this information is not about trying to get out of some BS that you got yourself into, he took the hit. Did his time in federal penitentiary. Not the county whatever or the, you know, traffic court jail. Big house. Did his time. Right? And came out, and guess what? He's still Rennie Bay. Mm-hmm. He's still using rvbaypublications.com as his source for information. He still, as soon as he came out, called his grand sheik, Kudro Adwo El, to let him know, hey, more, just letting you know that I'm out. Right?
Word.
Why? Because this is bigger than some situation that he had. This is about his birthright. That he did the time. We're not talking about somebody who used Moorish information and got out of something. Right? He got himself in a situation, guilty by association, same stuff that we're talking about in class today. He got himself caught up in some guilty by association, right? And had to do hard time just because you aren't showing niggers. So you get nigger treatment. But it wasn't no big deal. He didn't get mad at RV Bay Publications, and he didn't, you know what I mean, talk stupid like they did something to him. Like RV Bay Publications did something to him because he got locked up. Because he was saying that he's a Moor and he has a nationality card that he got through that site, but they still locked him up. And, you know, he's coming out, he's mad. They're not mad about, took responsibility, which eliminates the guilt. You take responsibility, you don't need to be guilty anymore after that. That's Moorish science.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Did the time. Came out, and everything's still good. He's still down with Canaan Land Moors and all that. He didn't jump ship because they kidnapped him, do whatever they did to him in there or whatever. Everything was still family after, because this is birthright. This is not some club joined Moor Science Temple. And I'm telling you,
right.
As Grand Sheik, and they like to say the name, who's the name or whatever. You guys just go talk to Kenyu Umar Bey. They call him National Grand Sheik. They call him Divine Minister. They call him whatever it is they call him. For me, you know what I mean? That's my brother. That put me through the attic chamber. If they got a problem with Kudro's teachings that he taught me, Kenyu Umar Bey. That don't forget, Moorish World TV has Kenyu Umar Bey on their channel. They push him. So why they got a problem with Kudro? If the guy who put me through the attic chamber, they're backing him. And he's not calling me. He got my number and all that. He got my Facebook and all that. He's not sending me no messages about why you letting Europeans do this and that and whatever. So who the hell are these clowns to try to tell me something? If the man who put me through the attic chamber isn't telling me anything. You lucky Noble Drew Ali said don't curse, because you guys will be getting it right now. Mm-hmm. You know, you guys are violent. Violent. The man who put me through the ADEP chamber that all these guys rate, they give him supreme 55 gun salutes and stuff like that. Kenny Umar Bey. He's the one that's his signature, his autograph is on our charter that we have at our temple right now. That's why I can say, forget Neil Bey and these people, because they don't got no jurisdiction over me. I wasn't taught to be somebody's grand sheik under some body of lowlives who haven't done nothing for 90 years. We're newborns. Eyes wide open, being knowing. Kenny Umar Bey was there when these Moors had their own plates and all that in Chicago. What are you talking about? What right to travel doesn't work? These Moors had fleets of cars with Moorish plates on them in Chicago in 2007, 2008. Go ask Kenny Umar Bey. How are these guys talking against right to travel? They rate Kenny Umar Bey. They give him respect. They give him Moorish honors, the highest Moorish honors. Trust me, he was there when these Moors would go to court and the whole court shut down. Whole court. Like the whole court. Nothing else is happening but whatever they have going on in that court that day. That's how Moors had it in Chicago. So you can let these guys fool you with a little BS or whatever. All RV Bay does is put out information. All Noble Jolly does work, bring you your nationality and birthright. It's up to you. Do you do whatever you want? Mm-hmm. But you better not violate nobody's rights. And you better not try to, you know, use this to get out some BS that you got into as a nigger. And you'll be all right. Ask Randy Bates.
I'm telling you. I just got to add, I see it all the time. Just one second. I see it all the time with, like you just said it, coming out of being, you know, the Negro colored and black, and you're still doing Negro colored and black stuff, and you got the card. And you just put yourself back into the jurisdiction with the card, and then you want to say the card don't work? And then we've got people all over the place, quote, unquote, work system, whatever that means to you. So it's, you know, or the information doesn't work? Well, if truth information doesn't work, what does? What do you think is going to work for you? But you're right. You know, doing the Negro colored black things, and here's why you do it. But this is with compassion and understanding, because that's all you know. All right? And until you get your information up by study, starting with whatever situation you may have, and using a reasonable mind, you will never know. You just won't. But it's understandable why that happened. But let's identify. You're bringing Negro colored black stuff into, you really are, into a Lodial national principles situation. That's it.
Islam. But you know what? I don't know, I hear a little bit of echoing. I don't know if that's me. But it's just odd because there's been so many Moors who have had, you know, their successes with standing on their rights, you know, in multiple areas. From right to travel to protecting their property, Fourth Amendment, to so many other different things that are constitutional. And I just find it ill because, let me start with this. From what I've heard so far, I didn't listen to this new wave yet all the way through. I was in the chat, and it was some woman on there, like you were speaking of, and it seemed from where I tuned in that her issue was she had mold in her home with her children, et cetera, whatnot, somewhere down south or Midwest or something like that. But let me say, you know, that's a personal problem, which is a health issue. You know what I mean? And depending on how you choose to go about that, that's your choice. But you also have the choice to cut the mole out and solve the problem. I don't know all the details, but things like that you cannot blame on RV Bay Publications. You just can't. Another thing is they were talking about the European boy who was supporting what Moors are doing. And it's like Noble Drew Ali did say, the Europeans are helping me. Why not you? And, you know, I do stand on the fact that there is some things where the line has to be drawn between Moors and Europeans. Like, there are differences between us, in fact and indeed. But what I'm saying is, as far as them helping for what they can do, I mean, it is what it is. Or as far as Moors, because you got to look at it. I know some sisters who was in the temple in Baltimore. We're talking, you know, as of this decade. And Moors in the temple in so-called Baltimore was letting Europeans come in to advertise for phone advertisements. So my thing is, don't front like they're not getting down with Europeans first and foremost, you know, to try to hit the scene as if they're not working directly with Europeans. Is deceptive in a sense, whereas, you know, keep in mind, these people, when they put up their videos, they're not putting up many videos of their temple sessions like Cujo is doing. Like, you get the Sunday classes that Cujo and the Moors and Canaanland, you know, activate and consistently do. These people are consistently alone with the camera on them, meaning what are they doing when they're off camera, right? Now, yeah, they might go and attend some events, but those temple meetings, though, are there Europeans up in there, you know, because I know for a fact a brother and a sister, you know, father and daughter situation, that was the case. They had Europeans coming in there advertising for cell phones, you understand? And getting members of the temple to sign up for that. So to act like they got a problem with commerce and people, you know, selling their products to our people is a contradiction that I don't respect. It's lights, camera, action. It's not legit. Like, it's hypocritical. So what I'm saying is, and I'm not going front, Sharif did wash Reggie up on that debate. But I'm saying, if it wasn't nothing else that Reggie pointed out, Reggie did point out that handshake between, or that eye wink between Sharif and that European. So these people who are, you know, really getting down with Europeans stepping out as if they are not, like, let's keep it 100. You know what I mean? Like, let's just, it is what it is. So, yes, I'm not giving, I know Reggie is not, you know, official like that. But I'm just saying, put it in perspective. You know what I mean? These people stepping out. And again, like I said, when it comes down to these Europeans, right, and the things that Moors are going through, the adversity, and I just want to say, I recognize now, you know, and more so now than ever, that adversity brings about a strength that you can't even really speak of. You can only show and prove. And we're definitely about to go way in, because I'm starting to, you know, something you don't really, nobody wake up like, yo, look, I want an enemy today. If you're living off the five principles, that's not how you're moving out here. You know what I'm saying? You're not, you know, though you might have had your days when you didn't really understand the five principles. You might have been like, yo, you know, we on the streets, anything goes, you know. I don't care about nothing, nobody. You know what I mean? If they got it, I want it, and whatever it is. And, you know, there were some people who had that mentality. But in reality, for Moors who are somewhat seasoned or just being themselves sincere, you're not waking up like, all right, yeah, I want an enemy today. Like, you might wake up like, I'm ready to defend myself against any adversity. You're not looking for that, you know what I mean? But it can happen. You prepare. You've been training. You got your martial arts up, your push-ups. You've been doing all of these things. You prepare for things, but it's not like, you know, just because you have a firearm doesn't mean you're supposed to shoot somebody. You know what I mean? And this is what you see even reflected in Roman militia, right? There's policy enforcers with firearms. Just because they got them don't mean they're supposed to shoot somebody. Same self-discipline goes with yourself and the things that you have. So what I'm saying is that with the adversity that is out there with some pilgrims and Moors, et cetera, you have to understand that it's nothing new. And that the things that are happening have been happening for centuries. Like, that's the truth. Now, there's been different histories throughout those things to remedy the things that has always been happening since back then. Meaning, you know, the Constitution was established because it was some malicious things going on. And you know what I mean? The rules had to be laid out because it was too ugly for everybody, basically. You know what I mean? That was more so an element or ingredient in the inspiration. So things haven't always been all good. You know what I mean? There's certain good that comes out of a certain bad. It's what you make of the bad situation. So what did the genius minds do? They got together, right? Moors, you know, made Christians or Englishmen or pilgrims or Europeans accept a law that was perpetual. And not even was, because was is past tense, but that is perpetual and still stands as law today. So when we look at these things and we move from that point of view, knowing what these pilgrims are obligated to, not just what they do, like what our ancestors already shedded blood for, because there's a lot of bloodshed today, but people are like, look, my ancestors already shed blood for me to have this right. And I'm standing on that. And I don't care what you say, because all of the prophets, the true prophets, excluding the false prophets, have directed me to this point of law. You know what I mean? The sages, if you want to, even if we're talking about those in this age. And when I say that, I'll specifically say Noble Drew Ali to distinguish what's real from what's fake. Because if Noble Drew Ali is saying to enforce the Constitution, and then the Constitution is telling me I have rights that's not even enumerated that these pilgrims have to respect. Why? Because if I look at his work, he's talking about our ancestors being on the Western Hemisphere prior to the pilgrims, or in even to the point where modern history, the Roman venues had to acknowledge that on a grand scale. I'm talking about proclamations, right? And no matter how you want to look at that, these are acknowledgments of the fact that these societies recognized that Moors was already on these lands. So I take that, and I'm studying law, and I'm looking at it like, well, I understand there's four categories of jurisdiction, all right? And territorial is not one really trying to forget, because it's so connected to who I am. You know what I mean? Being here in North America. And I think a lot of people neglect that fact because they're just attached to the continent of Africa, or what's called Africa today. But you know what I'm saying? So when we take all of this into consideration, and we know there's a distinguishment, and we know thyself, because a lot of these people don't know thyself, but apparently, you know, or these are they got on the regalia and all of that, but they're in spirit and soul and substance, it's not with them. You know what I mean? And there's been people who knowledge of self really wasn't with for a long time now, meaning that you always had those who wanted to be free from enslavement, and then you had those who were content and would advocate or justify being enslaved. You know what I mean? Like, they made it acceptable. And this is what you're seeing today, even when it comes down to the topic of when, you know, Morisco World, et cetera, is trying to bring up Corinne Gaines and all of these things. And I speak from my own experience as well, whereas I've been in de facto courtrooms and the Pilgrim magistrate, European, is telling people, like, not just your license is suspended, like, physically give it to me. And if they don't have it on them, they give them 24 to 48 hours to come back and physically give them that license. Do you know why? I knew why, but there's so many references to why, because, you know, even when you look at the definition of license in the Henry Kimball Black's Law, Fourth Edition Dictionary tells you that license does not create a vested right, and it's not a property right. And it doesn't create a property right. So your license is not, or the license is not your property, which is why they could say physically give it to me, and because it never created a property right. So it's permission, you know, and that's really what it is. Now, who are these people to really put a stop on your movement in life? That's the real question. And do you consent to that? Because when we look at them, you know, I can speak from my perspective, and I'm pretty sure there's a lot of Moors who feel like this. You know, when we're looking at these pilgrims who we know, since law and history go together, we know who we are. Our ancestors been here for centuries, millennia, ab initio, you know. When we do a comparative analysis between our existence, Pan's existence, we know there's no possible way they could have territorial jurisdiction. There's no possible way. Unless you consent to an artificial construct, then the consent creates a different jurisdiction, if you will, or not even that. Well, yeah, an agreement subject to a jurisdiction, which will also be called terms, et cetera. But a license is not that. Like, it doesn't create a property right, so it's not yours. So, you know, your right to travel is yours. Your existence is yours. Like, if you was to lose everything you had today, you still have you. So that's your right. You have a right to exist in the condition you made, you know, and elevate that condition. You know, if you feel as though you may be in a lowly state, you have the right to elevate, to become a better being, you know, to progress, to digress. It's life. It's about choices. So my thing is this, not to get too far off, but my thing is, when we look at this, you know, people say they are Moors, et cetera, and that is true. Like, because Moor, being a Moor is your nationality, birthright. That should be as common or more common than the fact that our Moorish people think or thought they was Negro, Black, and colored. Like, that should be known that we're Moors, just as that common. But, they misrepresent what's going on, what we're doing as far as what's been done, et cetera, you know, just providing information. And this is what it is that can be researched and checked out. So my thing is this, mothers and fathers, you know what I'm saying, correlating with the situation that was being spoken of before we started, I would say that, like, yo, if you're going to reproduce and have children, just make sure you can provide them with the proper environment. You know what I mean? Don't be blaming RV Bay because you and your quote-unquote baby daddy, quote-unquote, I'm telling you, quote-unquote, baby daddy fell out and all this other stuff, and y'all feel like that's somebody else's fault? Like, no. Like, you might have came across some information looking for the remedy. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's like if, like, we study the Constitution, right? We know if nothing else, you're starting with the first 10 amendments. It's the easiest thing to remember in the Constitution. Like, the easiest thing to start with memorizing, honestly. You want to read it from front to back, but to memorize some very key points, those 10 Bill of Rights, that's so easy to remember. Write those down, et cetera. But when I know that and I see that these people have an oath to this situation, you know, to this Constitution, I'm not going to blame the Constitution if they violate it. Like, it's not the Constitution's fault. You know, somebody who took an oath violated that oath. It's not the Constitution's fault. It's their fault for violating that Constitution. So the same thing likewise, if somebody is providing you sources and information, you can't blame the source for the information. Who is it that really violated it? That's what you have to focus on. And I think a lot of quote-unquote brothers are not focusing on that because these are cowardice who just want to argue amongst themselves, et cetera. And I tell you, you got to look at what these people say because, you know, these are people who said they've been in the temple 27 years. This right-to-travel situation isn't nothing new. RV Bay Publications didn't make it up. Nothing new. Stop playing with us. There's cases from the early 1900s on the right to travel. You know what I mean? From the 60s. And I mean, or locomotion and by ever what will you dictate. So, yeah, that's a right. You know? That's a right, definitely. You also have a right to not be, it's so many rights you have that get violated. You know what I mean? So many rights. So, there's this concept of good and evil that's going on. And that's the real issue that's underlying everything. So my thing is this. Yeah, I know Europeans are not Americans, and a lot of them feel like they are. Some of them don't. Some of them really, really want to be Moors because they know their history, and thus they know that they have no history that didn't include Moors from ab initio, you know. And they know what the nobility is. So a lot of times they practicing that behind closed doors, and they know that the Moors are the nobles, which is why they have those things on their fezzes. They have Moorish appellations, all of these things on the fez, you know, that they got pinned down, all of this. So they know who we are because they know who they are. And they always aspire to have the position of the nobles, which is where we are at right now. So they want to be Americans. Why? Because or they claim or, you know, have people perceive that the true Americans or Al-Moroccans are some beggar nation called Negro, Black, and Color that doesn't have any, you know, these are displaced people as far as that concept goes. So they don't have any attachment to the land. You're talking territorial jurisdiction. They start talking about slavery in Africa. And you're like, well, look, we was already here. And even if you thought you just came from that continent across the Great Atlantic, like it wasn't attached to this land, but, you know, how did a Pilgrim 1492 get jurisdiction over you here without your consent? I mean, in these days, like, how do you still consent to that? Like, because it's one thing to know it exists, and there's certain things you might have to do in certain situations, but with no situation, you're just like, oh, no, I was a descendant of a slave, and, you know, but I'm a god, though, and we was all over the planet, but, you know, I don't care about America. It's just crazy. So we waving territorial jurisdiction all over the place, and I think that these are concepts why you have Moriscos who have accepted the will of the Christians and try to impose it on other people as if they shouldn't. Like, now, if you accept that, that's a choice. You have a right to choose. Nobody's trying to say, you know, nobody's holding a gun to anybody's head saying, you know, if you don't do this, somebody's going to kill you type of thing. Like, no. You know what I mean? There's been people who've been shot down with driver's license, reaching for their driver's license, it's a realer issue going on. And my thing is for Morris to not address that, and also the fact that Mansoor Barbey was an MST of A member. He was an MST of A member and got shot down by the police. And these people didn't give him a shout out yet. Like, yet. MST of A member. You feel me? Like, what's that about? But I tell you, I'm watching. I'm listening. Okay, these dudes act like they got respect for Taj. Like, I'm telling you, this is the reality. To Harker Bay, he did something. Pujo sent me the link as well. He did something yesterday, and I was listening, and he's like, yeah, Taj was out here for a while, and he does a great work. And, you know, I admire that. And now we got to piggyback off that. But I'm like, hold on. You've been in this temple 27 years. 27, this is what he said. 27 years. And you don't have nothing as of now. Like, who's the true fool? You know what I mean? Like, what's really good? If you've been in the temple 27 years, where's your room to speak right now? Feel me? Like, all we have to show is a YouTube channel, which is great, but what I'm saying is we got to use these platforms for what is more ameliorating to the true point. But what I'm saying is with the adversity now, it's like, okay, we could definitely turn up. I feel it, you know what I mean? The season is here. I see, like, it's nothing new, but attacks are real right now. So all I'm saying is I'm thankful to be here, you know, and I'm riding with you all. We here.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, let me say this, if you will, and I don't want to cut you, but and Kujo, because you know the Europe, the specific European they're talking about, Brother Latif, and I know that you have spoken with him, and we know that yes, as I said earlier in the beginning of this show. Of this broadcast. Modern Europeans, Prophet said, Europeans are helping. Why not you? This is your Negro problem. Now, and I also said, and we'll make it clear for the record, this particular brother, European, excuse me, is why got through on our protest. And that's when we realized that modern Europeans were trying to get through. Now, we're sitting here, so, you know, we explained it. It's not for you. You're not the, you know, the national. So that one got through. I don't know what they're talking about with what didn't work for him, but if he was trying to make the claim, it wouldn't work for him. Now, I'm not saying that it doesn't work for Morris, who makes that claim, proper or improper or whatever, however they mix the apples with the oranges, because I know for a fact that we mix those who, like I said earlier, who have the card, you know, bring in the wrong information and come with the still with the Negro mentality and try to gauge it up against, you know, a load of information, and that won't work. And I understand now why the prophet said the card will change in your pocket, because, again, as soon as you get that, and as you mentioned earlier, Ms., you broke down the territorial jurisdiction. That's the very, 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 very first thing they do all day long. They violate you. And then in their paperwork, in their paper processes, they'll send you something that says in the jurisdiction of the city of, you know, whatever, you were speeding on, you know, Fifth Street. How many people recognize that's a territorial claim? And if you don't recognize it's a territorial claim, then take right there, because you have to. You have to rebut that by simply saying in the territory of, in the jurisdiction of my ancestral state / national domicile of North America. That's how you have to start. You know, so I want to say, so let's just get it out there. So now I didn't want to drag this. The fact that this European got through, and that's why we changed our processes. Not against them, because you know we have to understand something as well. a lot of the modern Europeans today, they're just getting this truth too. That's not that doesn't mean it belongs to, you know, the card or the claim belongs to them. But they're going to get their lessons on that as well. It's time for everyone to confess their wrong. That's where it is. Simple as that, and have understanding, overstanding, and understanding of what it is you're confessing. Everyone has to be forced to do that. So we just want to put it out in the air. Yep, that was inflicted and dug through and found that. But it's all good. I would like to ask this question, though, Cujo, because clearly that the temples are membership, you know. And back in the day, what did the prophet offer any type of membership card, but not nationality, specific to modern Europeans who were involved? Because I do know that those who were and carried on his work, modern Europeans I'm talking, they opened up, is it the Orthodox? I think they call it the Orthodox Temple. Do you have any information regarding that?
Yeah, as far as the membership of quote unquote Europeans in the temple, there's no records of Europeans being members of it, but they did support it. They did support Noble Jawali's program. Right?
All right. All right.
So
we want to make that real clear.
There is a connection there. Because it's information.
Right.
We're looking at him like the prophet. They're looking at him like somebody bringing information. And his information ties to them. Because when they trace back their Irish whatever, it's going to go back to Mars anyways.
How about that?
They're not tracing back. They're not tracing back some Irish and bumping into some Europeans to say that's their history where they go back to. They're caught.
Yeah.
They're caught.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
Yeah. There's no option for which is where he's coming from, because there's no option. Like, okay, so I traced it back and it goes back to Mars now. So, okay, so now what am I gonna be? I might as well be more. Put a fez on or whatever like that and be more.
Mm-hmm.
I know from a perspective of pigmentation, I don't qualify. I know that. But when I trace the history back of whatever bloodline I claim as European, it went back to dark skinned people. There was a time
Absolutely.
When people who I say I come from as European stock or whatever, there was a time when they were dark skinned people.
Absolutely. All four corners.
So,
mothers and fathers. Yes.
So what do you want them to do? What do you want them to do? To be, if they go to the cave, they're still gonna be Mars.
Mm-hmm.
If they go to Argentina or whatever like that, they're still going to be Mars. Because they're caught. Yes, it's amalgamation, but, I mean, yo, like I say, you know what I mean? He will be classified, called whatever, European or whatever, right? But trust me, I'll put him to bat before anybody on Morisco World TV.
Mm-hmm.
I'll make him paint it before any of these guys. Why? Because he studied the information, fact checked it 3-4 times, even got locked up. Even got locked up. And still, you know, just like Rennie Bay, came out and ain't nothing changed, ain't nothing to be mad about. You know what I mean? I'm going to be mad. Because, you know, what people don't hear about, is the fact that when he got locked up, he was in there telling these guys about their mores and all that in the jail. Which is why they immediately got rid of him. And gag ordered him and all that stuff like that, because the jurisdiction that he was in was being controlled by so-called Freemasons. And they weren't having that. But then, you know, what are they going to do? Because he's saying more is subject. He's saying, I'm using the Great Seal because I'm a more subject.
Exactly.
I am not you dot S citizen or whatever like that. I'm not that. I know what you guys are doing. And you're not going to put me in your jurisdiction to have jurisdiction over my body, because I might not be, you know what I mean, you know, human being or whatever like that, but I know that I'm living, and I know that you guys are violating people, and you're not going to violate me. So if I know that in my studies I found out that, you know, there's a jurisdiction where you can live just being who you are, once you're not violating the laws or whatever, well,
exactly.
I'm going to go there before I go anywhere else. If I'm a foreigner, if I have nowhere to live, if I have no home, I'm going to go to the place where I will be accepted easiest, because I don't really want any strain because I'm a foreigner.
You're right, exactly.
On that strength, he's talking how he's talking. He's not talking how he's talking because he's trying to pretend to be a Moor, or he wants to use Bay because, you know, the power of using Bay opposed to a European name and crazy like that. That's not the perspective that he's coming from.
Right. Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Exactly. Now that's interesting because, you know, you're right. And this is where, when you say, like, he knows he's a Moorish subject. All of them are Moorish subjects. We're not Moorish subjects. And so he recognizes that, you know, and it's
right.
It's like we can't even, you know, we thought about it, and I think I had sent you a copy. We were thinking about writing up a proclamation. In fact, we did it, but we just not have not done that process yet. Because first, the modern European has to understand that they're not the priority in terms of proclaiming, you know, the ancestral estate at this time. Anyway, we're having enough trouble trying to get our own people to. to be in order. Like, why bring them in, you know, and say, yeah, you're a Maori subject, and here we can issue that necessary proclamation for you. You know what I'm saying? Like, if we were going to do that, which may happen. But our own people.
This is why, to the second part now, why there was the Moorish Orthodox Church.
Exactly.
Because these Europeans realized, hey, hold on a second. We can't be Moors, but we can be Moors subjects, and we can create a jurisdiction once we're living under the rules that the Moors have set forth, which at that time would have been Nobel Drouali. So they studied his literature, and they had their own passports and stuff like that. Europeans.
That's it. Right.
They had their own.
They had their own.
You know what I mean? Like, they had their own European abolitionist movement to try to get Europeans to not be white and all that, and go back to their heritage. And that Nobel Drouali's teachings are supposed to make them better people and stuff like that. This is the perspective that they were talking in the Moorish Orthodox Church, which was Europeans.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh.
When we look at that, that's the Europeans. That's the perspective of the ones that we would need here. Everybody else needs to get the hell out of here. Like, if you're not coming with the perspective of recognize Nobel Drouali, recognize that the jurisdiction that you're under is the Moors, and that Moors have superior claim regardless of what you claim, then everything will run smooth.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Right?
And
because we already have our jurisdiction.
Mm-hmm.
We already have our culture, customs, and all that. It's not. The issue is that, and it always comes down It always comes down to Cain. It always comes down to Set.
Mm-hmm.
Always comes
mm-hmm.
down to the evil brother.
So,
right?
Yeah.
The people that are amongst our ranks are the issue. The people who have turbans and fezzes on and are fighting dumb fights, like just creating confusion for no reason. Like there's
exactly.
no reason for what to have been going on for the past 2 days. Like there's no reason whatsoever.
I think they just want to be heard, want to be, you know, get attention
exactly.
and stuff. That's
exactly.
what I get from it.
Right. And that's exactly what it is. Right?
Yeah, I think,
and
yeah.
it's for you know, there are people who want that. That has its own jurisdiction that, you know, there's people who that's what they want. You know, hey, cool, do your thing. But you don't have to, you know what I mean, try to run people through the mud who are wearing the mud protection suits. You know what I mean? Like you're not it's not you're doing more harm. They're doing more harm to themselves than good.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
This is how you know that it is deliberate propaganda. Right?
Yes.
Not against RV Bay Publications and Taj Street Bay, whatever, against Noble Drew Ali and what he brought for the nations. Don't look at that they're violating RV Bay. Look at it that they're violating Noble Drew Ali. Forget RV Bay and Taj Street Bay and Cujo and whatever.
Yeah.
They're violating Noble Drew Ali's platform, which is an open platform for uplifting fallen humanity, which humanity is everybody.
Exactly. I mean,
humanity is everybody. Universal profit.
Now,
but
I'll tell you where. No, I'm sorry, go ahead. I'll tell you where it's bringing us to the next level. Now, here's the thing. The next level of teaching, of sharing information and others on this line and who are listening, of studying next level. It's forcing it because it has to happen. And that is when you had mentioned that when you go back to all four corners of the earth, we are the mothers and fathers of civilization on all four corners of the earth. And you find dark melanated Moors, first navigators, as the mothers and fathers, right? Excuse me. So the question begs, where did the modern European come from? So now you have to understand what the true meaning of Negro is, what the true meaning of Black is, and why they put out Darwin's theory, and why, when you talk about bloodline, like you said, there is a mixing of bloodline, and the bibliohelotext says, look what you have wrought. So now we got to talk about those origins and how these people, like an Englishman, if you look it up, it says we are but a hybrid. They're hybrid. This is what we actually birthed them into slavery. That's why they're called Slavics. So now that's the next lesson. But if you can't get the lesson of who you are, how can you possibly get this next lesson? And let me tell you how Prophet Noble Drew Ali brought that lesson when you get to the 102s. And this is what I'm looking for at this moment. Oh, my goodness. It says in the 102s, right? You notice if you have one, here it is. If you have one, it never, ever, it refers to Yahshua as Yahshua, not Jesus, because they know by now you've gotten 101 lessons and you already know that he is Yahshua. So you will never find the word Jesus in the 102 because this is whom you have graduated and you got that. But when he asked the question, and I don't know why I can't bring this up. Okay, when he asked the question, it becomes number 86. Now, 86 in the 101 is named some of the marks that were put upon the Moors of Northwestern Mexico by the beast Satan in 1774. Clearly, this is the coining, Negro, Black, Colored, and Ethiopia. Because we know Ethiopia means a dividing line, right? It's not a land. And then, but in 102, the number 86 says, what is meant by the word Negro? In the 101, it says, what is meant by the word Negro? That becomes number 86 in the 102s. And it says, Negro is the name given to a river in West Africa by the Moors because it contains dark or black water. Because you know, Negro means, in certain languages, means dark or black. 87 in the 102. In reality, now this is the question that's in the 102. But again, if you haven't graduated from the 101, then hey, that might be why you need to study that wonderful word there. It says, in reality, what is a Negro? Now this is the prophet, he's telling you. In reality, what is a Negro, right? Not what is a name given to something, but what is a Negro? And the answer is, and the prophet gives it, he says a Negro is that has four legs. Now, he's not setting you up towards your further studies to understand what and how, we, as scientists, we went in and grafted this being, all right, who knows they are but a hybrid. If you look that Englishman up in Oxford's dictionary, it'll tell you we are but hybrid. But see, this is the next lesson that is, it's hard to receive this lesson if you won't even receive the fundamental lessons and you're running around and like you said, attacking everybody because of the information that's being put before them. Only to beg for you to go and check it out and study to so that you can show yourself approved. That's all we're doing. It's giving information. You got people out there that want to knock information, and then we give the elementary stuff with just even current day rules, laws, you know, the Constitution, the violations of your rights. Article 1, you have the right to associate with whomever you want. That means that nobody can force you to associate with these corporations or anybody or anything or any group or any corp, anything at all. And you won't take that position and say, oh, well, you know, well, they said we've got to do this, and they said we've got to do that. Well, that means you missed what Article 1 said is your inalienable, unalienable right. I'm not saying that you don't have to associate, but you missed it. But why did you miss it? It's missing from you, but why? Because of the mental slavery. Back to when the prophet said, I came to take you out of your mental slavery. All right? So all of the answers are already there because principles don't change anyway. But now we want to run around here and there and over here and over there and then talk about the obvious that seems to be the obvious with your fleshy eyes, not realizing that you create your reality from the unseen. Well, you can't get to that, obviously. So that seems like, oh, that's a higher degree, but here you go. So there's your sign right there on what a Negro really is. But you didn't get that in the 101. You got it in the 102. Not only did you in the 102, you would get it if we studied. So I'm thinking that the time is coming. And the other reason I think that time is coming is because of all of the books that are now out written by modern Europeans telling the truth about the fact that they were the original slaves over in Britain, which is why they wanted to be free from the British, which now people call the English, but the English is the fiction. It's British, the brutish Moors, and that they were the original slaves over in these lands because the British brought them over here. So when you read the book, and Left Them Here to Die, and that's when, and of course, that's a mistreatment, that's inhumane, and that's when the natives or Moors who were here that they want to erroneously call Indians, but this is not India, you know, was helping them to survive, or trying to anyway. But So this means that the next level, this is how we're going to deal with this. Let's go to the next level of learning. And those who are not going to be able to get on that train, that bus, that boat, so be it. They'll still be sitting there with the camera shot on them talking trash of what they don't really know, you know, because it's negative energy and it's to gain an attention. And there's a lot of people trying to gain an attention without first, you know, receiving this information that they need to receive within themselves and then simply sharing it. Don't be trying to be anybody's leader. Nobody's guide. I mean, you know, we all are a guide. Everything can be a guide. But, you know, think about it. Who can knock information? That means these people don't want to be free within themselves, and now they want to grab you and don't want you to be free either. And how do we do that? Throw stones at others, judge, and all that. You're in the wrong space of mind if that's where you're at with it. So that's what I'm thinking, that it's just time. It's just time for the next level, because that's where we're going. Like you said, Kuja, what did you say? They're throwing something and we already have the suit, the protective suit on. What word did you use a few minutes ago? Are you there, Kuja?
Sorry, I was on mute. Say that again?
You said something about they're throwing something but at people who already have their suit on, their protective suit on.
Oh, no, you know, yeah, dragging the mud, yeah.
Yeah, they're, oh, mud protective suits on. Right.
Yeah.
Exactly. Trying to find some other dirt. Taking you through the mud, still looking for something that, like, it's craziness. It's just, it's out of order. So,
I'm not thinking they're trying to.
Go ahead.
I was going to say, so what?
No, go ahead.
I'm just analyzing it. It's crazy because, excuse me, the importance is to know it all boils down to the fundamentals that, you know what I mean? It's like I'm analyzing this and I think that either these people are deliberate agents.
Yes.
Or really miss the fundamentals. And I'm thinking more so agents because we already know what time it is when it comes to attorneys, you know, being officers of the court. So for, quote, more, you know, in the temple to actually be, you know, like promoting an attorney opposed to understanding, you know, being impropria persona, I think that's also just as worse, if not worse than or equal to, you know, promoting a Moore who is for that designed, you know, Englishman, European system. Because I'm telling you, fam, like I'm telling you, like I tell you from experience, you know what I mean, that the worst type of gatekeepers, the worst type of gatekeepers are definitely people who look like us. And the reason why I say it feel worse is because you would expect a little bit more, you know, understanding nationality and birthright. When I went to file writs, yeah, there's some European women who could get funky. There's some European males who could get funky and act like they don't want to, you know what I mean? And they got to examine and ask their supervisor because there's been, you know, this is just crazy. But, I mean, the it feels the worst, like when the sister is at the window and is carrying out the European agenda to violate your right to due process of law. And this is not bashing the sisters. I'm really not. But it is a reality that some of them are frontlining for the European pilgrim programs. Now, I hear something clicking in the background. I don't know why.
That was me. That was me. It's all good.
All right, true. But yeah, so just because they put a Moorish face, like if you understand what they stand for, like what they are, what they're doing, you know what I mean? Who they're working for when they claim to be working for you. You know, don't let them try to say, don't let them say, oh, well, you know, somebody studied under RV Bay and they got 7 years. Like, they didn't get 7 years because of RV Bay. They got 7 years because of, you know, I'm sure there was violations, but, you know, things that they did, all right, and then look to RV Bay for a remedy, et cetera, which there's plenty of information there that you can find and research and cross-reference, et cetera. So, you know, if a Moor takes a hit, it's not the first time in the world. I don't want to see that happen to anybody. Don't get me wrong. But I'm saying there's been kidnapping going on for centuries. You know what I mean? For centuries. And how many attorneys representing people, and these people are doing football numbers with representations of attorneys. So, like, keep that on the you got to put that on the Libra scale. You can't just say that because we're talking justice. So if you're saying, oh, well, somebody dealt with LRV Bay and they got 7 years, look, they're not legit. Like, come on, fam. We could go through a laundry list. Like, we could dedicate a wall that just might be able to like, the list could run concurrent with the Great Wall of China. I mean, they got memorial walls and all of these things. But if we list all the attorneys that took cases and the clients that they represented doing time right now, it's a very long list. It's a very long list. So there's a corruption in the judicial system, period, regardless.
Period. Right.
You know what I mean?
But they're supporting people, that corruption.
Yeah, no, it's blatant. It's blatant. However, there are some who are, you know, navigating correctly and understand that from an international perspective, all of that is foreign. You know, we're Aboriginal, Indigenous, and they're foreign. And they have no jurisdiction. And we're not getting off that because this is what it is. We're talking identity. So with that comes a lot. Who are you? And then ask yourself again, like, who are you? What are you doing for who you are? Right? And those who are who you are. So, in other words, you and your people, what are you doing for them? If you know who you are and you're being yourself naturally, like, if you, and you would have to know, like, seriously know who you are, naturally you would not be working with pilgrims, like, up under their jurisdiction like that. Like, as far as I'm dealing in the slave auction blocks, but yet you're an officer of the court, and you already know that an officer of the court is an officer of the court, meaning they're subject to the jurisdiction. They're working for the court, not you. Bottom line, and if you know that in conjunction with being impropria persona and being yourself, there's a force that's with you. Attorneys wouldn't even want to represent you. I was just talking to my brethren today, you know what I mean? And they hit him with a false indictment, and he went on a special appearance, and they told him straight up, like, you know, you can't have effective counsel. You cannot. There's nobody who could represent you. This is what the Magi told him. So, I mean, in the essence, if he didn't want to waive that right, he didn't have to. But he fought his fight before, and they already know what time it is. You feel me? So they're looking at it like, we know who you are. We know we can't represent you. They will only play that on the weak-minded, so that they can make more finance off of them, because the attorney got to get paid off the bat, you know what I mean? Or you have some of them who say they'll you know, they want to get paid if they beat the case. And then, you know, that's contingent upon what deal they make with the judge before you apparently beat the case anyway. So, you know what I mean? That they still just making finance because it is what it is. So my thing is, like, in these days, to not know who you are and to not know who the Romans are, it's dangerous.
Dangerous.
You know what I mean?
Very
like,
dangerous.
It's really dangerous. And it's like this. Whether you're moving with just a nationality card or a so-called driver's license, there's a serious threat on you. And I don't even want – now I want to say that to put anybody in fear, but there's no difference in that aspect because, look. Look, we had the realest stop ever, you know what I mean? So I'm not, you can't tell me, you feel me, that, I mean, I've had the best and worst traffic stops ever that anybody could ever imagine, fam. Like, no, real talk, like real talk.
Yeah.
I had the best encounter and the worst encounter. I had them both,
mm-hmm.
You feel me? So you can't tell me things is not are not real, you feel me? But what I'm saying is to never acquiesce, you know, but if that's your choice, it's a choice. And just because somebody is telling you that there's no hope, there's nothing we can do, you don't have to believe that. You know what I'm saying? You don't
that's
have
right.
to believe. You don't have to rock with that. Now, I understand that it does feel like it's hopeless. You know, sometimes you could feel like that. But I liken that to the fact that, you know, it's still a finish line to cross. It's like if you're a track runner or you're a sports player, you know, it is what it is. Like, you know, there's going to be times where you get fatigued, you know. It just is what it is, especially when you're putting a lot of energy into what you're doing, the mental fatigue. You know, physical fatigue, all of these things. So you might have to, you know what I mean, take a little break, come back, you know, whatever. I liken that fatigue spot to sometimes it feels like it's hopeless. When it's not that, you might just need to take a time out and, you know, refresh yourself and get back to it.
Because victory
yeah,
is
you
assured.
Feel me? But,
because
but,
victory
but
is
it
assured.
Gets to a point where if you are fatigued, yeah, you can't keep, like, you might not be able to keep moving at that time if you reach your absolute, you know, apex with your fatigue. You got to get your win back. You know what I mean? You have to. It is what it is. But you're going to get it back, and you're going to keep it moving. So my thing is, it's not hopeless. And I know it's a challenge. It's the challenge of all challenges. We're talking about the concept of good and evil. Like, we're talking about the myth that had people shook, which they didn't understand, between the God and the devil, which is good and evil. You feel me? Like, devil, evil, right? So, God and devil. God is good, devil, okay, evil, et cetera. This is the yin and the yang. This is here. You know what I mean? We can't deny that. It's true. But a battery wouldn't operate without both of those energies. Feel me? Mm-hmm. Like, your car battery couldn't start your car if it wasn't for the negative and the positive. It wouldn't go
that's
anywhere. So, you know what I mean? You have to consider all of these energies is what molds creation. Like I was saying earlier, the Constitution didn't just come about because somebody thought so one day, like, no, it was a series of events for certain things
yeah.
where the natural law had to be reinforced, you know what I mean, in the tangible realm for man or for mankind too, in that matter, when you consider all parties, pilgrims being involved, the Europeans being involved, or mankind, etc. So, or modern Europeans for that matter. So, from a series of events of things that happened, they tweaked. They was like, listen, y'all are at a point where you can reason that if you shoot the deer is going to die. So this is what we got to do. We got to make peace because things need to live. So let me just say that in correlation with the hunters and the hunted, because everybody was, there was a point where everybody was being hunters, or not everybody, but a lot of people were hunters, meaning there was a lot of people who was prey and killed. And killed. It was war, in other words. So from the results of that on a mass level, there had to be an agreement to stop it. You know what I mean? There had to be the contract, which was the Constitution. Why does it apply to the Europeans today? Because it was for posterity between two nations. So they like, listen, you know what I mean? Like, that's what it is. The, when the contract was made, it was so much energy that went into that Constitution as far as making it so valid, you know what I mean? Like, seriously putting the spirit in it, you could see it. If you just read the 10 Bill of Rights, you can see, like, what's going on right now, that there was some genius mind somewhere. And you could also see that there's some evil geniuses in correlation with that, because it's like, damn, everything this is saying is exactly what's being violated every day in your face. So you either look at it like, wow, well, the ancestors had great provisions, which are great, you know, for protections. Then you're like, hold on, but somebody also had intentions to violate this. You know what I mean? But what's that about when you check all of these people's backgrounds? They have an oath to the Constitution. Bottom line, they have an oath to this document. So for them to violate that document, you know, among other things that are protected via that document, you have to realize what the problem is. And then you had those who started thinking like the colonists, and that's another problem. So now they're like, oh, nah, you can't move your land without your master's permission. But, you know, this is what we're looking at. So you got to be aware, you know, be yourself, know yourself. Know that if the power is in the people have a responsibility to move with power or force or enforce the Constitution. So it fails when the people get weak-kneed, telling you, I know, I understand, I do understand. But when their knees get weak, this is the only thing that can make the body collapse in that regard, or, you know, because you're not supporting the body, you know, and this is what it's about. So it's about being firm, standing on your square, and knowing that if the power is in the people, what is it that the people collectively aren't doing? That shit is out of control right now. Excuse my expression. But how did the people let this get that far out of control? That's the real question. You feel me? Like, how? Mm-hmm. And even if we say we know how, with all these complaints, when you look at who has the obligations, right, you need to know where to place that. That's really what it is. And again, like I said, good and evil exists. So I'm not saying indulge, but I'm saying you have to have balance to all of this. So, you know, self-defense exists. So, again, you know, and I know people don't like to talk about it, but the Second Amendment is powerful. You know what I mean? The Second Amendment is powerful.
Yeah, we won't go there because we have people who are off the chain right now. I do want to say this,
Hold on. Let me say this. I don't mean to cut your wisdom, but I say the Second Amendment is powerful in a unified way, because in there it speaks about a well-regulated militia, like, so the individual, but the collective too. Feel me? Like, not just the individual, the collective, for a common cause. So when you see who's against you, you see before, I'm just saying, it comes in a point where we have to do more than know it, you know what I mean? Like, and be it. Because when the Bundys took over, and these was pilgrims, the Bundys did that out in Oregon and took over with firearms and beat the case. Some of them still fighting, et cetera. But that goes to show you, you know what I mean? Now, I know people are going to say, oh, well, yeah, they was Europeans. Of course they could get that off. Look, man, when we collectively put our energy into something, you know, we can do whatever, specifically when it comes to territorial jurisdiction. And I know some arrogance going on, too, specifically with the pipelines going through Northwest of Mexico, et cetera. But being said, I'm going to yield the floor. I mean, to cut your wisdom. All right?
No. It's fine. That's fine. I was just, you had mentioned earlier, I took a note on it, on reframing or setting back. And, you know, just to give a little astrology lesson on that. That's a very important thing for beginnings and ends, and that means for everything, because it's a cycle that doesn't close. And that would be representative in the 12th house, Pisces, where and what's really interesting is that Pisces also represents enemies, all of your enemies, and power over or success over enemies. And here's the deal. If you do not pull back, you know, and refrain so that you can, perfect your technique of whatever it is that you're doing or take that break, so to speak, if you will, as you mentioned, you know, then it will be your own self-undoing. And that's also why you, as those who are studying astrology or whatever, will see that Pisces represents, you know, in short words, let's say the house of self-undoing. Because you have to refrain to perfect your own technique, and you have to refrain, like you said, take a step back and really look at things. And failure to do so is why, on another level, Pisces rules, that house rules, institutions such as jails, prisons, and mental or insane asylums. That's the reason why it's there, you know. Because that's a necessity. So keep that in mind. And also, what came to my mind when you were talking about buckling at the knees, because, yes, it can get weary, but there is no rest for the weary. And as you said, the finish line is not there, and we have been told victory is assured. See, because at some point, as Cujo had mentioned earlier, they're stuck. It's like when they go back, even they're going back into Irish or Ireland or wherever they're going to go, they're going to find where the mothers and fathers did. You know, it comes from there. So that they come from this earth plane, and we are the mothers and fathers of civilization and civilization principles, period, right? So now this is what the prophet said. It's going to be in your hands, Morris, but see, here's the thing. Are you going to be prepared? Where are you going to be? I know you're going to be wherever you can solve your problem best. That we know. That's just sensible, logical. But this is what it's about. So if you don't have this information and you're still bickering over dumb stuff and don't know who is who and what is what, you know, when it comes back in your hands, what are you going to do? But those who stick to the principles, all right, or know the principles and stick with them, and, you know, we're trying to start something new. There's nothing new. The new world order is really the old world order. And if you don't know that, you're lost. Now, the other thing as well, mentioning about attorney or using an attorney, I mean, there's so many things that brings you to these points of realization, I think. But just looking up the word and propria persona in the dictionary, it tells you in that definition, you weren't even looking for anything that has to do with an attorney. But that's where you find it through your study, just looking up that word. And it says, Pleas to the court must be made in propria persona. If not, they are made by an attorney. It gives leave to the court. That's what it says. And that's how I said, wow, they're letting you know. Now, some people might be they read that sentence. Let me just say, they read that sentence and it says give leave. And because they don't know what leave means, they don't understand what that said. So that's when you would go and look up leave. But it literally means gives jurisdiction. So now, as you were saying, if you know that an attorney is really it's your adversary, that they speak for people who can't speak for themselves, then you know that can't be. You can't use them. And I also want to add, there's a lot of Moors who went through this thing talking about, I believe, I'm not sure how the statement went, but something about they got their own attorney general, or they got power of attorney or something. I mean, you know, all of those roads that they went down only showed the lack of knowing. I'm not even going to say study anymore. Lack of knowing and putting ourselves into jurisdictions that we do not belong in at all. So you got people who have these contracts, paperwork, and their power of attorney or something to that effect over themselves. And it's just like really, it's really nasty. It really is. But it's all going to come to a head, as we said. And lastly there, when you were talking about the license, well, how many people know that you can't even use a license? That's coming to a dead end. Matter of fact, got 6 more months. That's 180 degrees, if I'm not mistaken, on the time frame where they're not to be used. The driver's license instrument is not to be used as identification. But see, that's because it never was identification. And so now, guess what? As you had mentioned, if they offer something to you and you believe that it is, and you think that it is, that's that mental slavery, then so shall it be in your world. And so if you are joining into that jurisdiction and into that world, then guess what? You're going to get whatever it is they got for you. And it's not good, because if anyone was good and humane, they wouldn't want to enslave you mentally or otherwise for their benefit. That is slavery, yes. And yes, we did, the brutish ones, our cousins, did establish that in a very bad, bad way. And so the karmic debt for that is what we are looking at now, but it is over. But some people are still stuck because they're in the mental slavery. And that's why Prophet came and said, let me take you up out of this mental slavery. Because he knew that you were going to know this day, this moment. You are not the Negro to call it order black, that you would know what occurred and that the taking place and reversing of roles, that that's what was going on, all right? That day would come and that day is here. So he gave you the information to help all of us up out of the mental slavery that has been bestowed upon us. So therefore, first and very foremost is to gain that knowledge through study, or gain that knowledge through whatever way, you know, because I know people don't like the word study, but through research or whatever, gain that knowledge so that you can be peeled off of that roller coaster of the mental slavery, because nobody told you were free, or you don't know that you are. But the world knows, and you're still running around in these fictions. But it's all really in your mind. So all of this is mental slavery. That's why he didn't say I came to take you out of slavery. He said I came to take you out of mental slavery. And so that's where we are. That's where we are now. Because look, it makes no sense for someone to show you an information what the drivers, as an example, just as an example, what the law says or what the rule is or the Constitution, as you mentioned, which was is really the peace document. That's all it really is. It's like, look, everybody, you know, if we all follow this, nobody will be infringed upon. And if you do infringe upon, here's the process on that. Did you hurt someone? You got to have an injured body in order to have any sanctions. That's right there. There's no sanctions against you unless there's an injured party. Now we're talking, you're talking physical injury, right? But then you're also talking that injury by contract, which is an agreement that you had to first make. in order to show that you violated the terms of that agreement. First, you got to have the agreement. Where's your agreement? It doesn't even exist. However, you know, you're making, a lot of people are making some agreements on the slide. They don't even realize what they're doing, going further and further and down the rabbit hole in a negative way, in reverse mode, really. But this is what's happening. So it's the mental slavery that you have to come out of. And that definitely requires you to have knowledge, just as Yeshua said, my people perish for this lack of knowledge. So it's not nothing new that we're making up, saying study. We're giving information for you to study upon, not for some scaring people or infiltrators to say, oh, that's not true. It is true. You can go check it out. It's true. Why doesn't it work, you would say? Because you're not working it. Because collectively or individually or as a group, you're not applying that which is. And when that happens, then, you know, this thing will be over overnight. That's why Prophet said it's a breakfast fight. But some people don't want to come to breakfast. They want to still hang out in folly. That's it. And as simple as I said, it is really as simple as it is, because all the rest is just a bunch of bull, a bunch of fiction stuff, a bunch of stuff to pull your mind into this wormhole of nothingness. It's like the Wizard of Oz. I mean, if there was ever a movie that showed you, I'm telling you, and that was done in black and white, what, in the 30s or something? Yeah, I think the 30s. And the most impacting thing, the whole thing was, but the most impacting thing of it, because I watched it last week, is at the very end, when she said, when the wise woman that they call witch, but they call her a good witch, because wise means a witch, or witch means wise one, or witty one. She said, I could have told you. She said, "What?" Dorothy said, why didn't you tell me that I could have just been home, that I was home, and all I had to do was click my heels 3 times? And, you know, if you click your heels, you're standing on the square, right, on the Sabbath. That's exactly right. So there's symbolism everywhere. But she said, I could have told you, but you wouldn't have believed me because you had to find out for yourself. And that's all that's being said. And assisting with information to help you hurry up and find out, and then people want to attack the information. There's just some sad, sick stuff for that. If you find it, you need to show yourself approved with it or whatever like that. And these people are definitely agents. And some of them are agents knowingly or being paid. Some are just, as you had mentioned, or what I would call scary people who don't have the hope, the faith, or anything, in anything. So therefore, they keep reminding you of what is happening. It's like, it's almost like their overseer saying, oh, did you see what Master did today? You know, Master went, and they stopped some people, and they shot them all up in the car. Or they pulled them in and hindered them and dragged them, you know, beat them up and all that kind of stuff. They're like overseers telling you what the problem is instead of putting energy into the fix. Because it is there. And here's the thing about the law and the Constitution. And Prophet Jesus said it. He said they don't want the law because it is too stern. It is very stern. And lastly, the knees being weak. Now, the astrology energy that rules the knees is Capricorn. What does Capricorn represent? Nothing but law, order, discipline, law, and order. So that's why your knees is weak. And so therefore you can't hold yourself up. You can't hold up the cavity, which is the hips and the thighs. And then from there, that's at the top, the north, going all the way up to the top of your head. Get your knees buckled. And then you take the polarity of that, because I'm telling you, it's in the sight. So if your knees buckle, you're falling. So if you don't have law, order, and governing principles in your life, you're falling. That's it. And what is the polarity of that? Cancer, the chest, the breast, the mothering, you know, the birthright. That's what has to be put in order. Lest you, scary as you be, it's all scary and, you know, whatever like that. And you know, your knees are buckled. because there's no law, order, and discipline. And I guarantee you, anybody out there that does anything that has to do with order, you know you have protocols to it. And you know that as soon as you break any protocol, it always goes awry. I found it to be true. I have protocols on what I do. You have protocols on what you do. As soon as you do that for someone, you know, and they say it's a favor, or they think it's a favor, and they go, oh, yeah, they did this for me because, you know, hey, I'm in with that. No, it was a breaking of a protocol, and it never goes too well when you do that. Law, order, governing principle, discipline is what we are striving for or where we're going. And that, if you don't have that, yes, your knees shall buckle. Islam, I think you mean someone may have had a comment, and if you do, let's do so. Otherwise, now I'm going to open up the lines for questions. No one has any other comments? Cujo, Miz?
I don't want to take the convo too far out, but just looking at some recent readings, there's some people who equate in tarot cards. Like, I know some people say it's a pseudoscience. I get it. I understand. But sometimes it'd be like prophecies in that. But they equate the devil with Capricorn, the devil card with Capricorn, because of the horns and all of these things. And I just wanted to add that on when you were talking about the knees and the lower self. Mm-hmm. And, you know what I mean? Like, these things kind of do remind me of that. And I'm not saying all Capricorns are evil or anything like that. I'm just saying that it is the lowest point of the sun in relationship to the earth, meaning that it's at the South Pole, if you will. It's aligned with the South Pole, or the lower part of the earth, because good and evil is all based off of the zodiac anyway, the six constellations and the six southern constellations, because you are a part of the universe. So higher, lower self, that also consists of universal, and they can't license that type of existence. Feel me? It just is. So when you know all of this about self, Noble Drew Ali is telling you, man, it's mine, and he's going into the soul and the attributes of the soul. You know, you should think a little bit more of your existence than being subject to pilgrims. I'm just saying, that's the bottom line. However you want to look at it, you say you a card-carrying MST of A member, you should be knowing that as well, because that's civics. You can still tie that in with the First and Ninth Amendment. So miss us with that subjective, what the pilgrims say, and we're not trying to, you know, be disrespectful, but it's international law, right? Everybody complaining about the system, quote unquote, the system. And these pilgrims already told you, it's laid out in the Declaration of Independence that when, you know, quote unquote, and I quote unquote, governments become too abusive and tyrannical, it's the right of the people to abolish it. Meaning that you have the right to say you're not legit if they're not operating according to how they're supposed to be operating. And for those who want to make excuses for why their master, because they're serving the Roman gods, is acting out of order, you know, they're going to try to get you to come on to their converso side and justify being conversos. Like, that's what's happening. So they're not standing on the divine and national. They're not getting the divinity of, or exerting or exhibiting or living out the concept of, you know, being divine and national, like knowing that you're that divine and national being. And that may be because their parents didn't think much of themselves or whatever the situation was. At the end of the day, ignorance of the law is no excuse. And when you get to that level, you know that that's the law of nature. So now we're talking natural law, which is what the Constitution was even inspired by, where any law should be inspired by or be inspired by. Any so-called law is contrary to the law of nature or the Constitution on American land, which is embodying the law of nature in multiple aspects, but can't enumerate everything that's natural law because it's so magnanimous that, you know, to waive that in all your splendor and all of your glory of claiming to be a Moor, claiming to be yourself, but then telling our people to just acquiesce and subject themselves on a public forum. That's sad. Yeah. That's info. This is not with no.
The internet is getting ready to go down. I just need to tell the people that if they can call in, they can call in, or with the phone number, or they can wait until the show is over and download the rest of the rest of the broadcast. What's up? Miss, were you finished? I didn't make that announcement. Well, I want to say this. You mentioned Capricorn again, and I will say this, and then we'll open up the lines. The other thing, you know, as you do your studies with it, Capricorn is the tenth house after the aspirations of the being and controlling of their higher and lower self, which is why the ninth house is Sagittarius, half beast, half man, et cetera, like that. And it's really, as you said, about the higher self and the lower self. But what happens is Capricorn is the 10th house, social house, and that is a direct reflection of your home, from your home, the fourth house. And so what happens is once you cross over the social orders, when you get to Capricorn, yes, it is the lowest point in the sun, but it's the highest point on the social houses. So it means this. You are what you are. How did your mama make you? Or, you know, didn't your mama teach you anything type thing? Because that house is the epitome of social status. The epitome. You supposed to bring it all there. Because that is the house where others see you as a direct reflection of what you are made of, if you will. All right? Because, you know, it is part of that self, being the cardinal point, self, being in that first house, Aries, how others see self, and then the fourth house being the house of self origins, which is your home, from your mother's womb to whatever the raisings were, and then directly from self is the seventh house, which is the first social house, which is Libra, and that's who you're going to associate with, mix your blood with, partner with, etc. And then you get to the Capricorn, which is direct from the home. And that's it. What you are is how others see you. So you got self. You got self-origins from the fourth house. You got self from the first house. You got self-origins from your fourth house. You got all that opposes yourself from the seventh house, which means who you hang with, your associates, what you do, all right? And then you have how others see yourself, which is in Capricorn, even if you don't see yourself. And remember, others see you more clearly when you don't see yourself. So I say that to say that that's the epitome of the social house at that point, and you are what you are, and if you need to work on some things, then, you know, fine, you know, but literally from the first six personal houses, whatever went on there, if you haven't fixed that or if you don't know what that is or if it needs to be fixed, it will reflect. And that's why people deal with Capricorn in that way, because you either want the lower self that you give to society or higher. Or that's what you're striving for, because the Capricorn strives up that mountain as well. That's it. So that's why it has such a lot of, that's one of the reasons, all right, because there's many, but that's one of the reasons, and that's why in secret societies they have that little term, don't let nobody get your goat type thing, you know what I'm saying? There's a lot behind it, but it's all based in astrology.
Oh, my gosh, you know what's real? I was talking about Capricorn, and someone told me just open up the light of Egypt real quick and go to Capricorn. And I haven't looked at this book in a while. And I don't know, I hear my echo. I don't know if that's your arrangement right now, but I just wanted to share this because it says, Kabbalistically, the sign Capricorn signifies the knees of the grand macrocosm and represents the first principle in the trinity of locomotion. So I'm thinking, I'm like, locomotion, that's the right to travel. If everything is a reflection of the universe and this information be accurate, in a certain essence, could we actually say that Capricorn governs the right to travel? I mean, in on another level, because, I mean, I know we govern our actions, but when you travel, it's about, no matter how you travel, it has something to do with the knees. Even if you're behind the wheel, you got to bend your knees a certain way to touch the pedal. You know what I mean? If you're on a bike, you got to bend your knees. If you're on the skates, you got to use your knees. If you're on a skateboard, you got to use your knees. If you're walking, you got to use your knees. No matter how you travel, it's something to do with your knees. So, I don't know.
That Capricorn's not getting up that mountain without.
You got to
use your knees. And so you just read that, right? And so you said locomotion, right?
It just hit me. Page 249,
yeah, right.
The Light of Egypt, Capricorn.
But check
go.
This out. The
yeah,
right
and don't
power.
Let him get your goat. Hold on,
yes,
hold on.
Exactly.
Hold on. Don't let him get your goat. Would equate to the Fifth Amendment. Don't let him take your property without due process of law, right? I don't know. I'm just looking at it a different way.
Well,
you know what I'm saying? The right to travel, right?
You
God
said
calling
locomotion. You said locomotion,
yeah.
So that's the definition of personal. Yeah, but
yeah.
That's the definition of personal liberty, the right of power of locomotion, of change, of changing one's situation or moving one's person to whatever place one's own inclination may direct them without imprisonment or restraint, unless by due course of law. So yeah, that's pretty cool. All right, so I'm going to open up the lines for anyone who has questions. If you have a question or a comment,
hold on.
Press 1 on your phone. Oh, well, was that you, Cujo?
No, that was me. I just wanted to add on another aspect about Capricorn and the right to travel. It makes a lot of sense considering Capricorn is an earth sign and we operate in on this earth plane, but at the same time, multiple dimensions, if you feel what I'm saying. Like, so I don't know. I think we're on to something with that. I really do. You know what I mean?
Exactly. Yeah.
And the NOI too. How come you don't know about Drew? Ask your teacher, Master Masons, or your Sifu. How come you don't know about Drew? Go ask the Reverend, ask your fam or crew. How come you don't know about Drew? Ask the warlocks of rap, sipping evil witches brew. How come you don't know about Drew? Elijah Poole is the Moorish national. Elijah Muhammad is the straw man shadow. York after Malachi is owned by the British. Zadok El is on the bureau waiting for the idiots. Mask of Gods is the Wapian's birthright. Teach from Wapian Moors paper they wanna fight. Circle 7 is the universal flag, I rep that. And Clarence 13X isn't my dad. Dua Lipa came first to save the mindless masses. Went from Moorish conventions to conscious classes. Went from pheasants to kufis to baseball hats. Went from Rasta to Moorish, replace our sash. Replace the RBG banner with a Moroccan flag. Replace Ras with Cheek, blacks get toe tag. Selassie triple crown is a fez with no tassel. Showing temple cards as ID with no hassle. Ask the Garveyite and the NOI too. How come you don't know about Drew? Ask your teacher, Master Masons, or your Sifu. How come you don't know about Drew? Go ask the Reverend, ask your fam or crew, how come you don't know about Drew? Ask the warlocks of rap, sipping evil witches brew, how come you don't know about Drew? Illuminate rapper masons, rhyming Morris science, hip-hop renaissance, reverse Earth's global climate, out the dark ages, many pages get burned without the chance to flip, be read or turned. No learning, blacks enslaved by the vermin, the Moors victim to Inquisition is purging, the government violating the covenant of contract, hip-hop general Iron Sheik, no squad to bomb tracks, Moors branded like Louisville slugger bats, with a name not theirs, void ab initio contract, most don't get it, cause they don't study the law, but they come from the galaxy behind the furthest star. To fight legal battles, they hire the bar. Who obtains leave cause you abandoned your rights thus far? Told you on Iron Sheik 2, no need to represent, just study the prophet and what he presents. Most don't stand for what he defends, most elders over their mouth, they need the pens. Higher self ascends, lower he descends. Conscious without a nation means he pretends. She pretends, which means we pretend. Pick up abandoned birthrights and the healing begins. Build on pillars strong like seven nodal twins. Iron Sheik 100%, most are partly skinned. Ask the Garveyite and the NOI too, how come you don't know about Drew? Ask your teacher, Master Masons, or your Sifu, how come you don't know about Drew? Go ask the Reverend, ask your fam or crew, how come you don't know about Drew? Ask the warlocks of rap, sipping evil witches brew, how come you don't know about Drew? Drew Ali. I'm going at dirty rappers, lynching dirty Moors too. Hiding literature that Drew wrote to warn you. They claim to make you Muslim and make you sovereign. With paperwork and filings, if fiat they robbing. They don't care about his words, throw it out like garbage. Or throw it at you when you're active, not passive. When they wanna talk about like off a trampoline mattress, treat them like a vamp or a teen actress. Get stamped with a brand like a mean savage. This Inquisition divine, all others average. Millennium Renaissance, heroes in our classes. Fed up with the czar controlling fascists. Ask if they heard about Moors, they say no. But Masons, they obviously know. Bound to handshakes and rituals with skull and bones. They even know about owls burning Bohemian Grove. I know what dirty Moors did to Drew Ali. I know what dirty Moors did, I know what dirty Moors did. I know what dirty Moors did to Drew Ali. I know what dirty Moors did, I know what dirty Moors did. I know what dirty Moors did to Drew Ali. I know what dirty Moors did, I know what dirty Moors did. I know what dirty Moors did to Drew Ali. I know what dirty Moors did. Dirty Moors killed Drew, I read the FBI papers. Unloyal Moors, emergency fund rapers. Moorish literature and divine bylaw changes. Might as well say Drew Ali was born in a manger. Prophets pushed poison aside and his food smelled danger. Got me treating every Moor like a stranger. Grand Sheik Ponkin stumbling drunk in their fez. What was proclaimed for every meeting was not read. Some Moors are so active, prophet can't be dead. Thanks Moorish teachers away, I can't be led. Actions speak, then I consider what's said. And what's said was study, then study yourself. Honest to the prophet, noble Drew Ali. I know what dirty Moors did to Drew Ali. Everybody wants to be just like Drew Ali, but nobody wants to care about Drew Ali.
I know what dirty Moors did to Drew Ali. I know what dirty Moors did. I know what dirty Moors did. I know what dirty Moors did to Drew Ali. I know what dirty Moors did. I know what dirty Moors did. I know what dirty Moors did to Drew Ali. I know what dirty Moors did. I know what dirty Moors did. I know what dirty Moors did to Drew Ali. I know what dirty Moors did.